dealing with the devil for his life, yeah. We all on the dance floor. Girl, come with a dance. Puerto Rican. In the even heavy. Little had my looking daddy. Couldn't tell him nothing because we lost him already. Cozy boy with his spaghetti. With the money and fame, the price come heavy. The price come heavy. Like Shaq attack up on a backboard. Gummy back up on a backboard. When she asked me if I love her, I just act bored. Say loser, ask for it. Living movie, blockbuster, this ain't a rental. Talking moody, all these diamonds up in my dental. I get never minded if I offend you. I need the silence, chaos is in my mental. You need a PJ, first class, not what you went to. You need to relay, chase money like Usain. I give you the boat, chain, and plane. Fame, name, that's insane. Pop the, nah. You need a, in case the movies get insane. Nah. You need a ruby, the kind of jewelry that's from the rain. No. I'm just here to remind you, but never mind me, man. I'm here to remind you where you come from. All this peace retreat is lame, done. You can never get rid of me, I'll offend you. Both of us, if I offend you.
It's one of them ones, man. You just in the car, man. It's like when you in the car, you just think about everything, man. Definitely when you by yourself and you just cruising on the highway, man. Yeah, this got me thinking. On that cap, swerving through traffic, listening to traffic. My windows ain't tinted, so notice me. Four braids, Yankee. Know it's me. I'm everywhere comfortable, but I'm still attentive. A young with money will make offended. I ain't flashy, I'm classy, but I ain't stupid either. Never show up to that's hungry and eager. My brother's keeper, I'm loyal, it's all in my demeanor. A true believer, I believe when they didn't believe her. That's why I don't let opinions affect me. I do what I wanna do. If they do or they don't accept me, they expect me to give up. I almost did. Things went from moving fast to slow motion. I was losing focus, stuck on that. It was smooth on the surface, but underneath it was broken.
All right, Coach, thank you. EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Baltimore Ravens and the Carolina Panthers. First running back drafted this year, it's Saquon Barkley. And he'll work his way across the 30 to the 32. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
On second down, here's Barkley, and he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue? Just make sure you feed me the football.
There he goes, left side. Touchdown, Carolina. Saquon Barkley hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. You talk about explosion plays. Here's one pretty much right out of the gate.
And now they get to ride a wave of emotion, momentum, everything. Just as you described, right out of the gate, big sprint, touchdown. They're excited. But on the other side, they've got to guard against a major letdown because they hit them right in the gut with that one. And now you start to question yourself a little bit when you give up the touchdown on the opening drive.
On the return, here's a dangerous Cordero Patterson. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10 at their own 26.
Detroit!
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. Evans has it left side. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch at second and 8.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
First catch for him. It's good for a dozen and a first down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up a touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now, or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
Throwing is Jackson. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. A big play that time through the air. 34 yards. Jackson on first down. Got a man. Caught for a Ravens touchdown. George Kittle with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. Santos with the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
They'll start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. He finds an opening past the 40. And he's into the clear. 20. Touchdown, Carolina. Saquon Barkley with touchdown number 2 in the game and now 11 on the year. And the Panthers strike quickly here for 6 points. And a pair of rushing touchdowns now for him in the first quarter.
And I'm liking what I'm seeing from his big guys up front because they're winning the leverage game. How many times have we talked about? Low man wins, right? Move the defensive front aside, create those gaps and holes. He's found his way through them for 2 touchdowns.
And after both of those touchdowns, he went right up to that O-line and hit each of them on the helmet. He recognized.
That's a smart man. You know what else he should do? If this continues, take them all to dinner.
And that should give his guys a spark. He's up all the way to the 44-yard line.
Well, you gave up the first touchdown of the game, but how about the response? Big time return. Now it's their chance to try and put points on the board.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 44. Try and run. No gain there as he kept it himself. It's second down.
Detroit! Over!
The first carry for the rookie, it's Darius Geis. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 10 yards there, good enough for a Raven first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. If he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. On first down, this is Geis. And a solid run down inside the 30. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. And he probably should have given that one off as he's going to get hit and taken down behind the line. He lost 4 there, and it's 3rd down.
Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. To the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Corey Coleman with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field. And they hit the home run last drive. 1 play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big time, John? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play action pass could very well be open.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it 2nd down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Here's a give to Barkley. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on 3rd down?
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
Oh, and they had it stopped short of the first, but a penalty marker down, and that looked like a clear face mask to me. So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a 1st and 10. After the penalty, they go with Barkley. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just 1 yard there.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
To Barkley. Oh, and now he bowls him over. A little juke. With my good friend Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you. It's the... So 3rd and 2, this quite possibly 4 down territory, though, if they're stopped. From the shotgun, it's Kaiser. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
Well, Timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10, just shy of the 30.
Gone!
After the interception, here's Jackson. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
And he's got Rome. And he takes it all the way down to the 15. A big-time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down. So he rips off a great run and shows you why this year he's top 10 in rushing in the league.
And looks like he's trying to move up fast on the leaderboard, doesn't he? Top 10? Looks like he's running to get into the top 5.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down.
Another scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down. On third down, Jackson. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Mark Barron. Well, they thought they were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. They were already in field goal range. But boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board. But give credit to the guys on the defensive side. Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
They begin with a run by Barkley. And he'll be brought down here at the 28. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. You talked about the need for them to establish the run early. They've been able to do that here in the first half.
And that means that the whole offense has adopted that attitude and that persona. We're going to take care of this young quarterback. Let's all get together and run it and take the pressure off.
Now Saquon Barkley. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
Flex round!
Third and short yardage, Kizer. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Now the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on 4th and 3. They'll run for it with Barkley. And boy, this is going to be close. That mark looks a little short, and he didn't get there. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. The 4th down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on 1st down.
Watch it now, Barney. Barney. Watch it now, Barney. Barney.
And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
Lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Now Jackson on second down. And he's going to be taken down. Back around the 35-yard line. Stephon Tuitt in there to get him for a loss of 5. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Jackson on third and long, and the pressure gets to him again. Mark Barron in there to take him down and to take us to the two-minute warning. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. Back with more from Charlotte after this. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. They're going on fourth down. It's Jackson. Now he'll let it go deep down the left sideline. And it's knocked away and incomplete. The Ravens go for it but come up empty. And the Panthers will get the football back. So the defense has to stay out and get one more stop. They were able to do it, forcing the incompletion.
So on their record, that goes down as a successful play. It doesn't matter how they got there, how it happened. They got it done. They're the ones that are jubilant.
Good starting position for the Panthers as they come up first and 10. They'll run with Barkley. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Yeah, and let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, your confidence rises, and he's running with terrific ability right now.
And he's able to get this one down to about the 40. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Some breathing room. And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Carolina. Saquon Barkley on his way to a monster game. 3 first half touchdowns. And the Panthers have broken our tie as they take the lead. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is now 21-14. The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Ravens offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Now it's Jackson being chased out left. Looking outside, and he's got a man. That's Evans. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. He got 29 yards that time.
on any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, it was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Flash the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still.
And this is caught inside the 5. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal.
Watch it now, Barney, Barney!
They come out here in the eye. On the ground, Geis. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. Now before the 2nd down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, 2nd and goal.
Detroit! Detroit!
They get it to him running left. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. Darius Geis in the final seconds of the first half. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. Santos able to tack on the extra point. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. This will be taken very short. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
This is Barkley. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Well, why don't we hold off on the halftime update after all? Seems like everyone's ready to go here for the second half in Week 8 in the NFL. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. It's a big play there for Baltimore. 47 yards. So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10.
Back in that Philly, here we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down. A very solid gain on that play.
Detroit! Detroit! Watch it now, Barney! Barney!
On 2nd down, here's Jackson. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up 3rd. They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise. Because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
He may try and run for this. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. A solid gain of 7 yards that time on the keeper and a first down.
Detroit! Detroit! All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Now a play fake here on first down. Buying time to his left. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Mike Evans hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Ravens have broken the tie. Santos out now. He'll kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. And he'll get to the 29-yard line brought down there. That throw good for four. It's second down.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other bats in the league.
And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards. What makes a draw play like that successful?
Well, we did see where he made the first wave miss, and that was a big part of it. But a lot of it is just being actors back there, making the defense think it's going to be a pass.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And he'll be taken down at the 34. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. We got three. They run it again with Williams. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And it'll be a third and about 13. Working out of the gun. Here's Kizer, eluding the pressure right. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
Quarterbacking 101. Never force the ball into double coverage, especially not this close to the goal line. The windows are so tight, you somehow force it in there because it could be tipped up and picked off.
And that will wind up just short. He had it online. It ran out of gas at the end, and this score will stay right where it is.
Well, he gets everything he could into this one. The trajectory's good. It's definitely online. They just need a little more oomph behind it, and it'll wind up falling just shy of the crossbar.
Watch it now, Barney! Over!
They'll throw on first down with Jackson. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. He was looking for Mike Williams that time. That'll bring up second down.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Second and 10. Here's Jackson again. The throw to the left side caught by Coleman. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. The Ravens on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This time they face a third and 2.
Lucky 56. Detroit. Gone.
From the gun, it's Jackson. Airing this one out for Evans. And that one incomplete. Had some position, but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down.
Finally, a good play there defensively on the deep ball. The secondary has had its struggles this entire game. Offensively, they've had their way with them.
Detroit! The offense staying out. They're going to go on fourth and 2.
Leppard!
Fourth down. Here's Jackson. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Ravens go for it, but come up empty. And the Panthers will get the football back. And he'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on fourth down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, you and I have both been to practices where we've seen, hey, third down situation, big third down alert, lock in here. Fourth down play, make sure you focus just a little bit extra. It didn't pay off in that situation.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
Kaiser now on second down. Flush to his right. He almost had it. The big D lineman nearly had an interception. Instead, it falls down incomplete. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here. Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands. Unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. He went backwards 5 yards there on third down to bring up fourth. Now, the offense failed earlier on the previous crack at this, but they're going again on fourth down.
Flex row!
And we're back now in Charlotte. It's the Panthers in possession of the football, but facing a deficit here. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Try it here. He's back to throw. Going to air it out deep for Gronkowski. And this will be caught at the 30. They go for it on fourth down, and it pays off big time as they pick up 29. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You stop to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
A first down carry for Barkley. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll try and run for it with Barkley. It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up second.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. Second down, throw for Kaiser. Escape. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Ryan Kerrigan, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year. So a tough spot for Kizer. The sack, and now it's 3rd and long. From the gun, Kizer. Over the middle, that's caught by Scott. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Well, they are able to get 9 yards out of that, but now it's 4th down.
Well, partner, they're still going to have to go for it after that play. And I'm not sure that the running game is going to be a part of what they have to do on 4th down now.
From this far out, you wouldn't think so. So an interesting call there to take the 3, and I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, 4th quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the air.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. They start on the ground with Geis. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a 1st down. Charles, you'd said the magic number was probably right around 20 for this defense because they're facing one of the top 5 offenses in the league. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Panthers have recovered.
I know when you're looking at the scoreboard clock, we're getting near the end of this game. But they were in what was really called 4-minute offense. And that's practice, being taking care of the football, taking time off the clock, not giving them a chance to come back. But bottom line is, what did I say in the beginning? Taking care of the football. That didn't happen.
Didn't do it. A costly turnover. They'll get forward for 3 down to the 16-yard line.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
They'll run it again with Barkley. And he'll get 4 there, down to about the 12-yard line. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is 3rd and 3. They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the 2-minute warning. And Ron Rivera, he's going to keep the offense on the field. They're going for it. They'll run with Barkley. He needed a yard. He didn't get anything. And the Ravens are going to get the football back. So the failure to convert, no doubt, really hurts. But this one's not over. A good chunk of time on the clock and the timeouts.
Yeah, not only do they have the timeouts, as you just noted, they're going to get an extra one with the 2-minute warning. And that's going to help them big way. So in a sense, they have 4 timeouts in their pocket. The big thing, stopping them on defense now. They can't let them get a 1st down and make them use their timeouts and get a fresh set of downs. They've got to stop them right here. And if so, they've still got an opportunity.
That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. 1st down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. They go play action here on 1st down. He's going to air one out. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 18. You got the slim lead late and the football, so why are you throwing it there?
Remember during the year when we asked one of the head coaches, you know, if you're in this spot, why would you throw the ball? And he talked about trust in his quarterback and trust in his offense.
But still.
And then at the end he kind of went, yeah, not really a good reason.
Now it's Barkley. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? Second and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Barkley. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. And that's caught by Smith. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. First down now, but that clock rolling.
Now you're right on the edge of field goal range. You've still got time, but get up to the line of scrimmage and get set.
They'll look to throw. They'll set up the screen to Barkley. There he goes inside the 30. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow. 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 I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
A score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Ravens offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. They're throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Back to throw. He's going to let it fly. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. He was trying to get it to George Kittle. It's tight end, and it's third down.
There's definitely contact there, but it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes the officials just say, let them play. Kind of like your mom used to, you and your brothers, just take the broom to you and send you out to the backyard and tell you to settle yourselves.
I like that. Yeah, there was contact. I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag. It was close, though. And able to haul it in is Kittle. And they work this well upfield across the 45. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. He'll look to throw. Flushed out right. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. These are the spots, this stage of the game, where it pays to have speed on the perimeter, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And in the second quarter, he may very well run by him. But in this situation, I know as a defender, I'm loosening up a couple of extra steps that allowed him to run with him stride for stride.
He's back to throw. Steps away. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
So many times we talk about having good eye discipline when you're playing defense, making sure your eyes are in the proper place on a given play.
Looks like that discipline came to the front there, didn't it? They were able to hold him for a short gain when he took off running.
The Ravens on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 9. Shot for Jackson to the sideline. Wow, what a catch. Doesn't get a lot out of it, but he is able to keep the feet in bounds. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for the Panthers, the win moves them up to 5-2 now on the year. And they'll get to stay home again next week as the Tampa Bay Buccaneers come to town. Meanwhile, for Baltimore, they'll fall to 5-3 with a loss. And they'll look to get back on the beam next week as they host the Pittsburgh Steelers. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
Anybody wanna be ET? Man, y'all can't see me. Out of my league, you peewee. Pocket too big, Rakishi. Pocket too big, they sumo. Pulling card like Uno. Flip like Judo. You back too kudo. You and her no chance, you go. Pocket too big, they sumo. 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 Pulling card like Uno. Flip like Judo. You back too kudo. You and her no chance, you go.
I sound